Save British Cameroon.
Yes.
We are standing here in front of the Commonwealth Secretariat. We are serving Cameroon here. We are calling on the Commonwealth to expel Cameroon from the Commonwealth because of the gross human rights abuses that are taking place in Cameroon for over 55 years. We are equally calling on the Commonwealth. We are calling on the Home Secretary. We are calling on the Foreign Secretary to intervene timely, or else Rwanda is in the making in southern Cameroon.
That's true.
As we speak, you can see for yourself, so many of our sisters and brothers have been killed just because they are standing for their right. Just because we want our freedom. Just because we want our independence. We were not part of French Cameroon. But because God had blessed us with resources, God has given us everything. And then now they are taking everything from us. They don't want to relinquish our freedom. They don't want to relinquish our resources. Sooner or later, they have destroyed all our institutions as we speak. Enough is enough, my people. Time has come for the British government to take the moral responsibility to restore the mess they left in 1961 and the UN. We cannot continue to endure these abuses anymore. We are a people. We are a distinct people with a culture, with a heritage, with a language. But right now we are lost. We are nowhere. We are just in the wilderness. We have no hope. We have no future. Southern Cameroonians graduate every day from the University of Boya. They can't even have a job for £10,000 a month. They have no life. So we are calling on the current this government to say enough is enough. What do we want?
Freedom.
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 Thank you.
Liberty. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to call on your attention again. The reason for being here, we are the right place, the right quarters. This is the Commonwealth Secretariat. Cameroon is a member of the Commonwealth. Based on the fact that we have English as our cultural language, based on the fact that we originate from the British, we are a British colony. That's why we are here. We are calling on the British Secretariat, the Secretary General, whosoever is there, to call on President Paul Biya to liberate us, to leave our educational system free, to leave our judiciary free, to prepare a good place for our children. We shouldn't be confused in the future. We shouldn't get education and be unable to work in our own land. That is what we are asking of. We are generally asking for a suspension or for President Paul Biya, who claimed to be democratically elected, to come out and do something to make sure we are free.
Leave Cameroon alone. French, leave Cameroon alone. That's my maxim. I'm here because I know France is the brain behind all these things. France is the main person causing all these problems in Cameroon. We are calling on the Cameroon government to come and listen to us through the president. We are calling on the Commonwealth Secretariat, the Secretary General of the Commonwealth, to see into our problems. They shouldn't leave us fall into the Syrian situation before they come in. It is too early. We call on them to come and save the situation now that it's early than late.
Anyone who hasn't signed this yet should sign, please. Those who just came, you can put your signatures on the petition that we are going to hand to the Secretary General, asking that Cameroon, one of there are three things we are asking there, that Biya should address the situation. He's completely ignored it as if it's not happening. It's shameful that a man who calls himself the president of a country was taking selfies with the footballers while people were dying in another part of the country.
Shame on him.
Can we have those pictures?
Very disgraceful. That man, 80 something years old, who is a father fails to recognize the value of young people's lives. When I watched yesterday the videos of him smiling and taking selfies, my heart broke when I could see on the other side young Cameroonians, students, fighting and asking for one thing: freedom. Freedom from a situation they did not create. Freedom to live in their own land as free citizens. The only problem they have is that they speak a language that was imposed on them by colonialism. We are here today asking the Commonwealth that in 1995, when Abacha contravened the Harare Declaration, Nigeria was suspended from the Commonwealth. Cambodia has done worse than Abacha, and the Commonwealth is quiet. We don't want double standards. We cannot support double standards. If the Commonwealth wants to continue to have some legitimacy, the action that they took when Abacha carried out gross violations of human rights in Cameroon should be taken in Cameroon. Gross violations in Nigeria should also be taken in Cameroon. They have a president. We are not just asking them to do something that they haven't done before. The Commonwealth, all the nations came together and suspended Nigeria from the Commonwealth. Abacha was put under pressure. Paul Biya, who is, or who claims to be in a democracy, has done worse than Abacha, and the Commonwealth is quiet. Those are double standards. We are asking Mrs. Scotland QC, the Secretary General of the Commonwealth, that if she wants to have some legitimacy, I've gone through their website. All the things they say they stand for, those are the things that our petition list, Cameroon has violated, every single one of them. The rule of law has been disregarded in Cameroon. Lawyers dressed in their official gowns and wigs were beaten by half semi-literate policemen. They were beaten on the streets, and those gowns and wigs, which represent
justice,
which represent law everywhere in the world, were confiscated by those illiterates who call themselves the policemen of Cameroon. These people confiscated the wigs of lawyers. That is a blatant disregard for the rule of law. The lawyers were protesting peacefully, asking for legitimate demands. When students of the University of Boya started protesting, they were chanting, "I have a 17-year-old student of the University of Boya."
She's in the hospital at the moment.
And she died.
Many students were killed just because they were asking for their legitimate rights. We cannot continue to talk about gender equality. We cannot continue to talk about gender rights when we allow young girls to be raped by the people that are supposed to be protecting them. Every message that the Commonwealth has to provide is useless if something is not done about Cameroon. Every message that they have on that website, I've looked at it, everything this office stands for is being watered down by the actions and atrocities of the Biar regime. We are not here today because we fancy just coming out in the cold. We are here today because it pains when you watch and you see your own brothers dying on the streets.
Yes.
Unarmed civilians. A 14-year-old went out to the shop yesterday in Bamenda and was killed. He was shot in the head. That was targeted killing. That 14-year-old was not doing anything to warrant being killed. A student was killed. Student who was simply in Bamenda to study, an engineering student, killed by the same forces that are there to protect civilians. This cannot continue to happen. It is time for us to stand up and say enough is enough. Enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
No to the killings.
No to the killings.
No to the rape.
No to the rape.
No to police brutality.
No to police brutality.
No to the rape.
No to the rape.
No to the torture.
No to the torture.
No to Biya's brutality.
No to Biya's brutality.
Enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
Anyone has
no to the destruction of our culture.
No to the destruction of our culture.